UK investors were catching their breath this Thursday after the FTSE 100 closed at an 8-month high yesterday at 68.20. However, miners stood out today with strong gains across the sector after Rio Tinto announced record production for iron ore, bauxite and thermal coal in 2013. But we're back to that retail sector, very much in the spotlight today after several players reported more Christmas sales. However, they mostly failed to shine. Shares in Associated British Foods dipped in early deals despite it announcing excellent Christmas trading at its Primark unit. In the 16 weeks through to the 4th of January, sales there at the low-cost retailer were 12% ahead compared to the same quarter last year. And Dixons also said it was one of the winners in the Christmas shopping battle, but warned performance for the rest of the financial year will be more subdued. Among small caps, Shanta Gold was supported by an encouraging update on its new Luka mine in Tanzania, which points to a possible extension of the operation beyond 5 years. And Richland Resources also hopes to get lucky in Tanzania and is set to restart mining at its Tanzanite operations in the country after exceeding the minimum it required from a placing and open offer. The miner will receive £2.7 million gross in total from the funding at 3.4 pence, with directors and five investors heavily backing the share issue. All this, as Beacon Hill Resources said, it's a step closer to being able to utilise the rail line from its Minas Motezi coking coal operation in Mozambique, following the completion of 5 purpose-built locomotives. The diesel units, made by RRL Grindrod, are expected to be delivered this quarter and will pull 90 purpose-built open-top rail wagons. And finally, Motive Television was also in the move after the deployment of its technology in set-top boxes by Turkish satellite broadcaster Digiturk exceeded expectations in 2013, with the growth expected to continue into this year. Let's look at some of the movers on this Thursday.